Hi everyone, I'm Brett from Laser UK. Today I'm going to be teaching us how to use the SD card feature on the Club Scene Laser. I'm just going to give you a brief overview of all the features on the back of it before we get into the SD card function. Firstly, we have the microphone and microphone sensitivity. These are used when using the laser in sound to light function. Beneath that we have DMX in and DMX out, which we will be using for the SD card features, but in a slightly different way. Below that are the dip switch settings, which you would use for setting the laser to standard DMX values. In the middle here, we have the SD card slot and all of the SD card functions below it, which are what we will primarily be looking at today. Underneath are the ILDA connections for using a laptop or computer to control the laser, but that's for another day. On this side, we have three mode function buttons, one for sound and DMX mode, one for SD card mode, and one for ILDA connection. And finally, we have the power input and the on-off safety key switch. I'm now going to show you how to use the DMX card on the laser. Before we get going though, there are a few settings that need to be checked. On the back of the machine, the SD card button needs to be depressed. That's the middle button. By default, the display should give you a DMX address. Out of the box, it should be 001. Most of the time, this is what we leave it set to. The most important thing you have to deal with on the back of the card are these three small buttons and this display. The settings we need to check are the DMX value, the orientation, ORT, and the intensity. These three functions are all hard set from the back of the laser. This will become apparent later on, as if we set them in software, this will override them, so they need to be correct. First of all, the DMX address. By default, this will be shown on the back of the LCD display. You can actually manually set the address on the back of the machine with these buttons. To do so, you would press the function button until it says address, then press the select button. You'll see the lights have started to flash. We now use the up button to change the address. And you'd use the function button to select which of the three characters you wish to change. For this, we need it set to 001. Once it's done, press function. Right, onto the next one, press function again. Orientation. This is important. Basically, what this does is it tells the laser how to project. So if you're using it for projecting onto a wall or projecting through a screen, you might need to change this. It will mean that you can change whether the picture is being shown upside down, back to front, or reverse, like a mirror effect. This one is set to orientation of 2, which means that the y-axis is inverted, but all of the functions are shown in the handbook that comes with the laser anyway. To change that is very much the same. You'd use the button at the end to change the value from a value of 0 to 8. Ours are set to 2 though, so we'll leave it set to that. Finally is the intensity. This is the most important of all, because if you turn this off from its maximum setting, which is 99, then you won't get any output from the laser in SD card mode. So with intensity on, press the middle button. As you can see, it should be 99. That's the highest level, and it should be left on that. If you turn that down, it will override any settings that you do in software. Now we're ready to set up the smart card in the laptop. So before we begin, we must turn the power off to the machine and then pull the smart card out of the laser. Insert it into your computer. And you will bring up all the files that are on the smart card. You'll notice that all of the ones on there, except for one, have got the extension .ild. The one we're looking for is the file called edit config. This is the one that will allow us to actually set the laser up so that we can use it with the DMX machine. So with that on the screen, press the edit config. You will then get the config.dat editor on the screen. And a little overview of this, we'll get into this a little bit later on, but for now we're going to use the very basic settings of it. So you'll see some drop down menus and some tick boxes up at the top where it says DMX channels. At the bottom of the screen, go to the load config button. It will bring up a menu. Select the file config. This is the only file that the laser will recognize, so we need to load this one. What we're going to then do is set up the channels on the top right hand corner where it says DMX channels. You will see that there are a few different drop down menus and options there. For this basic setup, we're going to set the laser into one channel of DMX, and normally you can actually use it from anything from one or even zero channels of DMX, one channel up to nine channels. We're going to be using this one channel of DMX, so this is all set. We need to save this config. So go to save, select config, and then save again. It'll say overwrite config, yes or no. We say yes, and that is done. Okay, now we can remove the smart card and replace it in the machine. Now we've prepared the smart card and the laser, we're ready to control it with DMX. I have now connected up a basic DMX controller, this is the DMX operator 2, to the unit, and we're ready to control the smart card for the first time. The way we configured the smart card earlier was to use just one channel of DMX to make the laser operate. What this will do in the most basic function is to only allow us to control the first 15 animations that are stored on the smart card. Now this is all plugged in, we'll turn the laser back on. And with the DMX settings at zero, the laser shouldn't give any output whatsoever in smart card mode. Once it's all up and running and the DMX address is set, I can now use the first channel of DMX to start selecting the shows. As I move the fader up, when I get to the first section, as you can see, an effect will appear and the laser will start to show the first display that's on the smart card. And now as I carry on moving the fader, continue moving it up to the next address, it moves on to the second. This will happen all the way up the fader, showing 15 different shows. So if I gradually do this slowly, you'll see and change as we go up. You get a nice star lines and circles. All these effects are actually stored on the smart card straight out of the box. You don't need to download anything, but you will be able to edit and load your own shows in at a later date. I'm just going to continue going up, show you what else is on the first channel. As you can see, there's quite a varied amount of stuff in the smart card, as well as animations which will be on later on. Almost at the top now. A few more effects to go. I think this is the last one. So with one channel of DMX, as you can see, we have access to all of these different effects, or any that we choose to load into those slots on the card. Okay, that concludes the basic settings, DMX settings for the Club Scene laser from Laser UK. We will be doing another video which gives you a more advanced overview of the functions that are available, more DMX options, and how to set up your own shows. So until then, goodbye for now.